for support, though.
Este chaval de aquí es André. And when I arrived here, I was arrived like complaining because I have problems in my hands.
Yeah.
I had a bike accident and I lost fourth and sensibility. And I was like complaining, saying I'm not gonna do that because I cannot swim more than a mile.
Yeah.
And when I arrived here, Juan Craveri told me, look at this guy.
Yeah,
I've been running with him. And when I first look at you, I said, wow.
Wow. So we say to people like you, or even some people, they're missing one foot, right? We say, it's a paper cut. You know, cry baby, it's no big deal. So yeah, you do. You know, you can't complain about anything. Nobody, not even me. You know, have a good life, have fun doing awesome events like this, meeting interesting people, awesome people, and so everything's good.
We have been suffering a lot, but during 3 days.
Yeah.
But you're all the time with a big smile in your face. How you do that?
I don't know, I'm just an optimistic person. It's inherent. I enjoy life. You know, life is interesting. It's not always, there's always positive, even though some things, like losing my legs, I was run over by a train, you think it's a tragedy, but the experience is life, right? So you find some interesting things about the world, about yourself, and continue on to the next thing. So that's why we do races like this, right? Not because we're maybe a bit machismo, but you live and you experience something new. So it's worth it.
Is that something that I can ask what happened to you?
Yeah, so I was in Czech Republic in Prague and living there for about 6 months. We go out with friends like normal, stay out late, drink, you know, too much. We had a breakfast and then I woke up in 3 weeks and in the hospital. So nobody knows what happened, but I ended up on the metro tracks of the train and I came around the corner. The thing ran over me and I lost both my legs. So what can you do at that point? I woke up in the hospital slowly and realized the situation, and I was first of all wondering if I would survive because I was in really bad shape. Besides losing legs, I have many internal injuries and all of this. And then I began to wonder if I would even be happy. Like, how can you be happy in this new disabled life, right? And there were some ups and downs, but then I just say, I'm gonna do what I can to just try, right? Try to walk with prosthetics, try to go live and do things that I enjoy. And I did that, right? So after I made up my mind, then I was not sorry for one moment about this accident. And I just go and continue finding new things that I want to try, meeting new people that have positive impact on me, and keep doing it. And so far, so good. So it's 11 years now. No complaints, since the accident.
11 years and with a lot of things that you've done all around the world with crazy people.
Yeah.
What have you learned?
I learned a lot of things.
Yeah.
It's always better with a smile on your face. Even if it's hurting, if it's painful, someone else can lighten you up with a simple gesture. You know, I'm going around the island and it's a difficult part coming up a hill. Somebody I don't know flies by in a truck, they honk the horn, they give me the shaka, and it's positive, it makes me feel good, and you continue on. So you can have this impact on people.
Hey.
on those around you. This is my wife, Mariana. She also,
she's your translator.
She's my translator.
Yeah, yeah.
Aire, come.
You speak too much languages.
No, no comprendo, señor.
Yeah. So, besides this lesson, I also learned that you just keep going. You know, sometimes life is the grind. When I was doing this race in Brazil, this ultra marathon, you're going up you know, 10-kilometer hill is like 25%, and it's 12 inches at a time, just really slow, a grind. But you just keep doing this and doing this. It feels like forever. It just hurts. It's painful. But then you break through the other side. And from the other side, you look back and you say, that was amazing. You know, that was living. And it's the same with the accident. It's such a bad thing, right? It's, you wouldn't want anybody to live through that, and it sucks, but you just keep going forward, and then you come out the other side. And I also say, wow, that was amazing. I feel fortunate to have experienced this in my life, really.
A lot of people, when I explain about these things that I do, or they watch the videos, they say, oh, but it's too much suffering. But at the same time, we enjoyed it a lot.
Yeah, absolutely.
How do you try to explain that? Because I'm not able to.
it's very difficult to explain. And there's times when I'm out there that I say, why am I doing this? Also, I say, this sucks. So there are these real moments where maybe I don't even want to do it again. And then the most, especially, you know, after, but you look back and you just see how magical and amazing this life is. And I think that's the same, you know, I think sometimes forward when I'm old and I'm really saying goodbye to all of this, and then I will appreciate it, you know, that I'll say, wow, how amazing this is that we get to see these things and do these things. And that's what this is, you know, we sort of suffered our way around the island, but we met amazing people. We see a beautiful landscape, even in the rain and these horrible conditions. It was thrilling, you know, and it was a moment that just stays with you and makes you say, hey, what else do I think is maybe not so good, but it has substance. Yeah, so it's a bad explanation, but it's part of it.
It's
part of
it. It's good. Yeah. What's next?
Next is probably vacation with my with my wife. I
Me
said,
okay,
if we go do this race, I promise we have a vacation afterwards. So we'll stay on the island for a while. And then I don't know. I had some big expeditions. I was trying with a friend to go do every continent around the world, to go from the lowest points to the highest points. Never been done before. We would swim, bike, paddle, run, and climb, you know, thousands and thousands of miles. So
to call me when you
okay I will
yeah,
I will
sure
we can brainstorm some funding for that and we're there. So other than that, I don't know. I mean, I didn't know I was gonna do this race 3 months ago. So I just see something looks good, go do it.
That's not the last time I see you.
I hope not.
And I'm
Thanks,
really
buddy.
Proud of sharing these moments, this dinner tonight, these 3 days with you. Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
For everything.
Cheers.
And thank you very much the other day for letting me pass in the massage. You remember that?
Yeah, because you have to drive a long ways. Probably because he didn't plan. I mean, maybe the Latin blood, you say, oh, there will be rooms, but no rooms.
No.
Anyways, no problem.
I decided the trip like 3 days before.
Yeah.
And we did it.
Yeah. It worked.
Thank
Success.
Thank you. Es el puto amo. Que tio es el puto amo.
Cheers.